Good evening and welcome to MTV's News Update, March 30, 2020 edition. I am Ashley Scotland. First, the top stories we are tracking this evening. GCOM chairman commits to votes recount. GCCI and GGDMA will not recognize illegitimate government. Full court to rule whether Justice Holder erred in ruling that he has jurisdiction to hear the recount case. Health Ministry projects 1,400 COVID-19 cases in Guyana. And in sport, Tokyo Olympic Games confirmed for July 2021. It is estimated by the Public Health Ministry that Guyana will record up to 1,400 cases of the coronavirus. However, resident representative of the Pan American Health Organization, World Health Organization, Dr. William Adukro, noted that the spread of the coronavirus in Guyana depends on the mechanism the government puts in place. More in this report.
PAHO WHO representative Dr. William Adukro today addressed the article which stated that all countries should plan for 30% of their population being infected by the coronavirus. At a press conference on Monday, he stated that the numbers coming from the Imperial College, George Washington Medical Analysis, and PAHO are just predictions and not actual figures that are to be expected. The articles had stated that all countries should plan for 40% to 80% of their population.
Remember that these are just predictions. They do not mean that anybody is saying that Guyana is going to have 30% of the population. There was another modeling that also came from George Washington University that said all countries should plan for between 40 to 80% of their population. Please note that it does not mean that anybody, not PAHO, not WHO, not the Imperial College, not the George Washington University's medical analysts are saying that we are going to get those numbers.
He noted that the number of expected cases of the coronavirus will be determined by the response mechanism Guyana implements. If response is done in an ad hoc manner, Guyana will have a higher number of cases, Dr. Adukro stated. Guyana currently has 8 confirmed cases of the COVID-19, with 1 death. 2 persons are in the intensive care unit and 6 in isolation. Luan Williams reporting for MTV News Update.
Marcus Bisram today walked free man after the High Court found there was no evidence to convict him. Bisram was extradited to Guyana to answer to the charge of murder committed on Fias Narayandat on October 31, 2016. The prosecution's case was that Bisram instructed men to kill Narayandat because he had retaliated to Bisram's sexual advances. However, the prosecution had no case as was cited by the court. Meanwhile, hours after being freed, he was rearrested. More coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Renovating or extending your current home? Or are you building your first home and need electrical components? Then visit Gafu's Electrical Department, your one-stop shop for all your electrical needs. You now have in stock electrical cable for your home. 2-core, 1.5mm and 2.5mm flat cable, complete with earth. Also available in heavy-duty sizes up to 16mm. Round flex cable, 1.5mm to 16mm. Switches in 1 to 6 GaN. Flush and surface outlets, junction boxes and connections, bulb sockets and much more. Single, double and duplex pole breakers, 2 to 30-way panels, voltage regulators and transformers. We've got domestic water pumps in half and 1 horsepower and pressure pumps 1 to 1.5 horsepower with 24 liters to 300 liter tanks. American-made Rood electrical water heaters in 20 gallons to 50 gallons. Split system AC units in regular and inverter types from 12,000 BTU to 36,000 BTU. And we're offering free installation. Remember, for the best services, quality products at competitive prices, it's Gafu's, the name you can trust.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
Welcome back. The trial of the case preventing GCOM from executing a national recount of votes will not begin until the full court rules whether or not Justice Holder erred in ruling that he has jurisdiction to hear the case. The full court comprises of Chief Justice Roxanne George and Justice Nareshwar Harnanan. A decision will be made tomorrow. On Friday, March 27, Justice Holder ruled that he has jurisdiction to hear the matter filed by Yulita Moore, blocking a recount of the votes cast on March 2. Chairperson of the Guyana Elections Commission, retired Justice Claudette Singh, has reaffirmed her commitment to a recount in the form of a sworn affidavit to the High Court. Here is more from Zandi Ramodar.
Chairperson of the Guyana Elections Commission, retired Justice Claudette Singh, has given the High Court an undertaking to conduct a recount. This was communicated in the form of a sworn affidavit to Justice Franklin Holder. APNU AFC candidate Yulita Moore has asked the court to block a recount of the votes cast on March 2, 2020. Justice Singh has submitted to the court that the Elections Commission has made a decision to conduct a recount. The chairperson made it clear that the electoral body has the constitutional power and mandate to conduct a recount. She pleaded a case for the electoral body to be allowed to discharge its constitutional duty and has confirmed that it was in the process of doing so. Justice Singh pointed out to the court that it should recognize that the Elections Commission must at all times act with fairness and impartiality. She said it is imperative that the commission be allowed to do so in a manner that will continue to inspire confidence in the electoral machinery.
Deputy Director and Senior Analyst of Global Affairs Canada, Michael Grant, on Friday tweeted that Canada is closely monitoring the legal proceedings surrounding Guyana's elections. He believes a national recount of all the votes cast on March 2, 2020 is necessary to ensure every vote is counted. Grant warned that the will of the people must be respected for Canada to recognize the legitimacy of a duly elected government. United States and Britain last weekend echoed similar sentiments. The Georgetown Chamber of Commerce and Industry, along with the Guyana Gold and Diamond Miners Association, has made it clear that the business community will not recognize an illegitimate government. Sandy Ramotar with the details.
The Georgetown Chamber of Commerce and Industry and the Guyana Gold and Diamond Miners Association in a statement said, "The transition of any government should only take place in line with transparent and democratic principles." The two made it pellucid that any government that swears in on the basis of non-credible results will not be recognized by the local business community. The GCCI and the GGDMA said it intends to take every lawful measure to resist and condemn an illegitimate government. The groups believe a national recount of all the ballots cast on March 2, 2020 will be the gateway to the declaration of credible result. The GCCI and the GGDMA is appealing to all the political parties to heed the calls of the international community for a credible electoral process. The groups have expressed concern that sanctions might be imposed on the illegitimate government. The GCCI and the GGDMA said it does not wish for Guyana to become a pariah state facing sanctions that would cripple the economy.
Still ahead, New Amsterdam imposes strict curfew and no oil shortage, Guy Oil reassures.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full-body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. With our wall and ceiling gypsum system, it's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Sherry Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick bet for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
At Decor and Gift Gallery, we have comfortable and unique living room suites. Check out your bonded leather sofa or three-piece recliner set and much more. Or pick a lovely dining room set to match your home setting. Whatever is your style, we've got it. Shop your living room or dining room sets at Decor and Gift Gallery today.
Police are investigating the circumstances surrounding the death of Yu Van Leeuwen, a driver of Kamkayuka Ideal Road Kurukururu Soosdijk Linden Highway. The 61-year-old man met his demise about 11 hours on Sunday, March 29, at Maipuri Backdam, Upper Mazaruni River. The victim was at the time under the water in the river, operating from a river dredge. Others who were on board the dredge observed that Leeuwen was not receiving oxygen or responding. As a result, a colleague went under the water to investigate and found him with his head stuck in the mud. He was then lifted and taken to the Imbabadai Health Center, where he was pronounced dead on arrival. As there is a suspected case of the coronavirus in New Amsterdam, the municipality has enforced a strict lockdown of the town. All residents must be indoors by 19 hours. More in this report.
A pensioner of New Amsterdam, Berbice, is suspected of having the coronavirus. She recently returned from the U.S. and has been placed in quarantine. It is against this backdrop that the municipality of New Amsterdam, on Sunday, on its Facebook page, said non-essential businesses will be closed with immediate effect, while others must be closed by 18 hours. All residents must also be indoors by 19 hours. Bars, hangout spots, beauty parlors, and barbershops have been ordered to close immediately. Supermarkets have to shut their doors at 16 hours 30, while pharmacies will close at 18 hours. Religious services were also placed on hold. While these measures were made by the town council, it is unclear how it will be enforced. It is also unclear if there is a law permitting the town council to install a curfew. Guyana has 8 confirmed cases of the coronavirus, with 1 death. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
The Guyana Oil Company has dispelled rumors that there is a fuel shortage due to the halting of many sectors due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Details in this report.
The Guyana Oil Company Limited, GuyOil, has assured that there is sufficient supply of fuel in the country to meet the domestic demand. This statement was issued to the press after rumors began circulating of a possible fuel shortage. The oil company said there should be no fear of fuel shortage, as Gaia Oil will continue to ensure fuel distribution across the country continues uninterrupted. Gaia Oil reminded, while international borders are closed, this lockdown does not include fuel tankers. More specifically to the global health threat, COVID-19, the oil company assured the nation that the necessary precautions are in place to ensure the safety of customers for business continuity. Guyana has not been spared by the coronavirus that is causing mayhem globally. Guyana has recorded 8 cases of the virus, which resulted in 1 death. Across the world, countries are battling with the effects of the virus, while doctors are scrambling to find a cure for it. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
A man who is accused of snatching 3 gold chains is nursing stab wounds at the hospital. According to information reaching this newscast, the 22-year-old suspect of King Edward's Street, Albaystown, Georgetown, and the victim, a 20-year-old construction worker, were passengers of a Route 42 minibus. It was when the minibus reached the Grove bus park and the 2 exited, the suspect grabbed the chains and told the construction worker not to say anything. However, the victim reached for a knife in his waist, whipped it out, and stabbed the Albaystown man several times. The wounds caused the suspect to fall to the ground and the victim took back his chains. This occurred about 13 hours 4 to 5. The suspect then escaped while the victim made a report at the Brickdam police station. He was then taken to the hospital by persons unknown and he remains there under police guard. More news still ahead. Stay tuned.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1-year factory warranty, along with our after-sales service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Start feeling good again with Probiotic XL. Probiotic XL contains a proprietary formula of 10 of the most important probiotics that have been researched and developed to help your body get rid of what's bad for it and help promote what makes you feel good. If leading a healthy life and enjoying every day is something you want to do, then Probiotic XL is for you.
Using Softex toilet tissue, available in leading supermarkets countrywide. Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, 6-pack, and 1 dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Gaffors, manufacturers of the perfect concrete hollow block in sizes 4 inches and 6 inches, certified by the Ghana National Bureau of Standards and hydraulically tested by the University of Guyana to 2,000 pounds per square inch. Pallet packed and shrink wrapped for easy transportation too. So get your supplies of the best quality made concrete hollow blocks in Guyana and also get a 12.5% discount. For superior service, quality and competitive prices, visit Gaffors Mega Complex at MacDo and our outlets at Rose Hall, Kanji, Bedford Acting, Memes, Land of Canaan, and Parika.
Welcome back. Now for your regional news taken from the BBC. The left-wing National Liberation Army, ELN, rebel group in Colombia has declared a unilateral ceasefire for a month starting on April 1. The rebels said the ceasefire was a humanitarian gesture amid the coronavirus pandemic. More than 700 people have tested positive for the coronavirus in the Andean country and 10 have died. The rebel group said it was also open to reviving suspended peace negotiations with the government. government. We declare an active unilateral ceasefire for a month from April 1 to 30 in a humanitarian gesture to the ELN with the Colombian people who were suffering from devastation because of the coronavirus. The statement reads, the ELN also said it wants to meet representatives of the government of President Ivan Duque to discuss an extension to the ceasefire. The rebels said they had been inspired to make the move by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres' appeal on March 23 for an immediate global ceasefire in all corners of the world. The Foreign Ministry of Norway, a country which has acted as a facilitator in peace talks in Colombia in the past, welcomed the temporary ceasefire and called it an important step in support of the vulnerable population and everyone who struggles for peace. The ELN has been fighting the Colombian state for more than 50 years, and previous attempts at reaching a peace deal have faltered. Over the decades, the guerrilla group, which was originally founded to fight Colombia's unequal distribution of land and riches, has attacked large landholders and multinational companies. It has also repeatedly blown up oil pipelines. Its strongholds are in rural areas in the north and on the border with Venezuela. It is much smaller than Colombia's more well-known left-wing rebel group, the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia, FARC, which signed a peace agreement with the government in 2016. One of the ELN's deadliest recent attacks was on a police academy in the capital, Bogota, which killed more than 20 police cadets in January 2019. Internationally, the government of Sierra Leone has overturned a ban on pregnant girls from attending school. The Ministry of Education said it was committed to ensuring all children had the right to go to school regardless of their status. In December, the West African Regional Bloc's court ruled that the ban was unlawful as it infringed on human rights. The measure was introduced in 2015 when an epidemic of the Ebola disease led to school closures and an increase in teenage pregnancy. Thousands of girls were affected by the ban, which forced them to attend special schools or leave altogether and forbade them from taking exams. Around 30% of girls in Sierra Leone become pregnant, and 40% are married by the age of 18. Now for your court roundup.
A construction worker today appeared before the chief magistrate, Anne McLennan, charged with the attempted murder of his stepfather. 29-year-old Darren Simpson of Lot 8, Plum Park, Sofia, was not required to plead to the indictable charge, which read that on March 24 at Plum Park, Sofia, with intent to commit murder, he inflicted grievous bodily harm on Morris Hines. According to reports on the day in question, the victim, who was the stepfather of Simpson, was about to head to work when Simpson threatened to kill him. Later in the day, when the virtual complainant arrived home and was exiting his vehicle, the accused reportedly attacked him from behind and struck him to the head with a wood. The man was taken to the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation, where he was admitted in a critical condition with injuries to the head. Simpson's sister, who was present in court, informed the magistrate that her brother suffers from drug addiction and would usually smoke, which would lead to him behaving in a violent manner. Upon hearing this, the defendant became annoyed and chased his sister from the court. Based on his behavior and his failure to remain silent and respectful in court, the magistrate ordered a psychiatric evaluation for Simpson. As such, Darren Simpson was remanded to prison until May 7. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
More news still ahead. Stay tuned.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
Now for your sport update. Guyana's national table tennis player Chelsea Edgell said the coronavirus pandemic has taken a toll on her life as an athlete, but she is doing her best to stay fit.
Edgell is currently in Portugal training for the now rescheduled Tokyo Olympic Games. She informed since the pandemic, she has been unable to practice and work out as usual, but she thinks it is vital she remains cautious and indoors. The athlete, however, tries to work out and do her regular exercises indoors, depending on how she feels. However, Edgell said she is taking the time available to interact more with her family and friends. The national player said she has also been keeping herself occupied recreationally otherwise while being patient. Earlier today, the World Health Organization recorded 5,170 cases of the coronavirus in Portugal and 100 deaths. Meanwhile, the International Olympic Committee today announced the Tokyo Olympic and Paralympic Games have been rescheduled for July 2021. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV, Sports Update.
Barcelona players will take a 70% pay cut during the coronavirus pandemic and make additional contributions to ensure non-sporting staff receive full wages. Captain Lionel Messi said the move was delayed as the players were looking for a formula to help the club. Juventus players and manager Mauricio Sarri agreed to freeze their pay for 4 months at the weekend. Spain's national death toll now stands at 7,340, making it the worst affected country in the world behind Italy. German sides Bayern Munich and Borussia Dortmund have also agreed to take pay cuts. Barcelona's board of directors, members of its professional sports teams, and most of the basketball team have also agreed to reduce their salaries. Leg spinner Davinder Bishu is set on making his return to the West Indies squad despite his struggles with a recurring knee injury.
Bishu last played for the West Indies in a T20 match against England in March 2019. Bishu told Cricket Nation 592, his therapy finished and his recovery is coming along slowly, but so far so good. He has played 36 test matches, 42 one-day internationals for a combined 155 wickets. However, injury has plagued his career over the last few years. Playing for the Guyana Jaguars in the 2019-2020 Regional 4-Day Championship, Bishu claimed just 5 wickets in 3 matches. The leg spinner managed to score 69 in 3 innings with 40. Bishu said it was good, but he did not get the best start he wanted after returning from an injury. He added, his aim now is to do well in the Regional Super 50 later this year and come back in the Regional 4-Day Championship 2021 to really get the attention of selectors. Bishu said he just needs to stay focused, train as hard as regular, and do well when his opportunity arises. Chelsea Lee, reporter of MTV, Sports Update.
The Tokyo Olympic Games will get underway in July 2021 after being postponed for a year due to the coronavirus pandemic.
The decision was made by the International Olympic Committee's Executive Board earlier today. The Games will run off on July 23 and run until August 8, 2021. Meanwhile, the Paralympic Games will now take place on August 24 to September 5, 2021. The decision to postpone both events was taken to protect the health of athletes and others. President of the IOC, Thomas Bach, said he is confident working together with the Tokyo 2020 Organizing Committee and others, they can master this unprecedented challenge. Meanwhile, President of the International Paralympic Committee, Andrew Parsons, added the priority for all of those involved must be focused on staying safe during this time. Organizers hope the delay will allow sufficient time to finish the qualification process, which will follow the same mitigation measures planned for 2020. It has previously been confirmed that all athletes already qualified and quota places already assigned will remain unchanged. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV, Sport Update.
And that brings us to the end of Sport Update. More after the break.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sale service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
Let's turn our attention to the Demerara Harbour Bridge and Burbies River Bridge schedules. This is where we wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. GCOM chairman commits to votes recount. GCCI and GGDMA will not recognize a legitimate government. Full court to rule whether Justice Holder erred in ruling that he has jurisdiction to hear the recount case. Health Ministry projects 1,400 COVID-19 cases in Guyana. And in sport, Tokyo Olympic Games confirmed for July 2021. Catch our rebroadcasts at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. And remember to keep your surroundings tidy, wash hands frequently, and avoid touching your face to prevent contraction of the coronavirus. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I am Ashley Scotland. Good night.